Hey, my friends, my clarity, confidence, and cash people. It is a beautiful day. I want to show you my Juneteenth shirt and wish you all a happy Juneteenth. This is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. And we've got so many reasons. There's a song called So Many Reasons to Rejoice, but we've got so many reasons to rejoice. You can see it's a beautiful day, and these little bugs are just buzzing in my ears. But I just want to jump on here for a moment and to talk about Juneteenth in its reference to what we've been trying to do in the group Lending Support. The importance for Juneteenth as it is related to this particular group is that, you know, we are standing on the shoulders of our predecessors, of our ancestors. And some of them, depending on what tribe you're from, have really all of them have sacrificed, but some of them to varying degrees more than others. But the importance is for us to know that we are here today because of all that they deposited in us. And so celebrate that history today, but also build on that history today. The part of the journey for this group of folks is to become your full authentic self. And part of doing that is to acknowledge your full authentic past and understand whose shoulders you stand on. They may have been sharecroppers, but they weren't always sharecroppers. You have to remember that they were stripped down to that identity. But those folks, you know why they had to be beat and stripped of that identity? Because they knew from the land that they came from, they were not just nothings and nobodies. They were proudful people, and they were in fact kings and queens in a lot of cases. And so one of the reasons they had to be beat was because these folks had so much pride, our ancestors had so much pride, that it wasn't going to be easy to just say, put this on and pick cotton. I can imagine the conversation went like, King so-and-so, or obviously they weren't referring to him as King so-and-so, but Solomon, pick this cotton. He said, I'm a king. I'm King Solomon. There's no way I'm going to pick this cotton. And they said, no, as you well know, your name is no longer Kunta Kente, but it is Toby, because here you no longer have a right to that identity. And so, and he still refused. You have to remember, he refused for a very long time to accept the identity of Toby, because he knew that he was of a promised generation. He knew that he was entitled to greatness. He knew that his thumbprint was unique and God had a purpose for him to fulfill. So they had to beat him. They had to beat our ancestors. We had to be beat. They had to beat that identity out of us. And that's why it's so difficult for us now to reclaim that place, because it was beat out of us, first physically, and then over the years, as we've been marginalized, it continued to be beat out of us. And here we are in 2020, and we're still dealing with some of the beat down. But I'm here to tell you that you don't have to do it that way anymore. We can acknowledge the past, and we can lift up. We can stand up. So I wanted to get on here and encourage you today to, yes, look back over that, acknowledge it. But here is the biggest homage we can pay to our ancestors, and that is to reclaim who they were before they were brought here. So knowing your lineage, knowing your heritage, knowing that you were originally made of kings and queens, you are a descendant of kings and queens, means we have to rise up. That we cannot let all of the beatings and all of the work they did go in vain. So you have to go forth in destiny. You have to become who you were destined to become, because you now represent the opportunity. And if you don't make it, then you need to build a bridge so that your children can make it. So I am on here right now, I said, to encourage you to go forth. Honor this Juneteenth by making a pledge to yourself to be unapologetic. To be unapologetic and to go forth in your right to be who you were called and destined to be. I love you, and I will talk with you soon. Happy Juneteenth.